Stay tuned for Relentless.
Yeah. Still goes on.
And somehow life goes on. Even when you wish it always stopped.
To me, it has everything to do with it. They're both, you know, they're connected. You know, you can't have one without the other. And, you know, and during the process, the growth process and all of those years of the repetition, same thing with reading and, you know, and studying and what does that mean, you know, spiritually versus physically, you know, and how the two compare. It's something that I, you know, put a lot of thought into, you know, over the years.
Getting the blood into the muscles, you know, over the years of training, you know, I did a lot of basic movements, you know, squats, deadlifts, flat bench, straight bar curls, military press, you know, barbell. You know, back then the weights were plastered with the concrete inside. So, you know, I had this little 15-pound bar along with those weights. I think the highest one was 15, maybe 25, I think it went up to. And I remember, you know, the feeling of what it felt like to get their first pump, that workout in. You know, and then through the years, you know, you start to see that development. That's when it really gets exciting, you know. I don't take for granted that, you know, the body, you know, it's a machine, and you have to treat it accordingly. You know, you don't want to beat it up too bad, but at the same time, you don't want to be too soft on it, you know. So I've learned to incorporate everything that I've learned from fitness into my spirit life, knowing that everything has to be broken down. Every muscle, every fiber has to be damaged, so to speak. Not obliterated to where it's beyond repair, but to where, you know, the body will collect information like, you know, protein, which feeds the muscle and which gives it the ability to repair. And as it repairs, it gets, of course, it gets stronger. So it won't have to go through that again. And just in case it does, then, you know, the muscle wants to be stronger. And it's the same thing with your spirit life. I mean, things have to be torn down, to be, you know, the ground has to be worked and tilled and broken up. But the end result is you're planting the seed. And of course, you know, shell has to die before the plant comes forth. And as it comes to, you know, the fertile ground and begins to grow, you know, the fruit is the last stage, but, you know, the growth process is going towards that. Ultimately, to bring about the fruit. And so it is with life. You know, spirituality, you know, it's the fruits. You know, it may seem like it takes a long, long, long time for things to develop. And, you know, that's one of the things I had to learn in patience, and that things take time, and it's better. You know, we plant gardens, and, you know, you reap it. You know, you get your tomatoes and your greens and your onions and all that, but you have to replant. You know, and those are quick returns, but in order to get something that will remain, that produces every year in a continuous fashion, you know, a tree takes, maybe it takes 20 years, but it will live for hundreds of years producing fruit, and you don't have to plant again. So, you know, I gear my life towards that, to one day, you know, when I come out of this shell. So in preparation that I want, you know, I train my physical body as well as my spirit body, because that is ultimately your moral. Immortality. But temporarily, I can keep this thing, if I can keep this body, if I can keep this thing alive and functioning, then, you know, it's all worth it.